Hello everyone. Today I will be showing you how to solve a few issues in Okta that are not too common in nature, but extremely time consuming when you come across them. I've personally encountered the issues that I will speak to in a moment firsthand multiple times throughout my career working with Okta and must admit that they were not only challenging, but extremely time consuming. This is due to not being able to diagnose or pinpoint the issue with logs as you normally would, since the Okta logging does not hint at a solution for these particular cases as easily as other problems. Not quite sure why, but I have raised the issue with Okta in separate tickets and hope to see them addressed in future Okta updates. My name is Alexander Markovic. I have 11 years experience as an IT professional working for a vast array of different companies and have used Okta for 6 years. I'm an Okta certified professional and would love to share some of my knowledge with you. Let's dive right in. As always, the first thing that you want to do is go to your domain.okta.com and sign in using your super admin credentials. Once signed in, you're going to want to click on Applications on the left-hand side and then click Applications once again. Go ahead and scroll down to DataDog and click on the chiclet. And click on the sign on button, scroll down, and then click on view under the SAML setup instructions in the bottom right hand corner. You're going to want to scroll down a little bit once again and go to step number one, which is to log into DataDog as an admin. You can do so by clicking your user dashboard and then scrolling down to the DataDog chiclet and launching it. Now, SAML isn't set up, so you're going to get the following error. What you're going to want to do is click on the go to standard login page and then go ahead and enter your credentials here. Now, for whatever reason, I had a little bit of a mishap with my sign in here. Even though I knew my password and username were correct, I was using a free account. With that said, it was not allowing me to sign in with my free account unless I actually clicked the try for free button and then entered my email, first name, password, and credentials again, which oddly enough actually navigated me back to the landing page of where you would originally land after entering your email and password or credentials successfully. Once you're signed in, you will be brought to the landing page. Now, in the documentation I was following, I don't actually see the little option, as you can see here, where it has a configure SAML button when hovering over your name. It's not showing for me, so I'm just going to go ahead and switch to dark mode here, and I'm going to go there by clicking on organization settings, and then I'm going to click on login methods on the left hand side and click on configure under SAML. Keep in mind, these button or UIs always change, so sometimes they actually vary from the video you're watching now or even in the future. Now, what you want to do is go back to the setup SSO page, and you're going to want to copy that content. And then you're going to want to actually save it as an XML in text editor. So what I'm going to do here is paste it right in there, highlight the entire contents, click on format, and make it plain text. Click OK, and you're going to want to ensure that it's XML. So once you do convert it to plain text, you'll want to go ahead and click on File, click on Save, and you're going to want to enter a name for it. Now, any name will do. I'm going to use the DataDog test.xml, and I'm going to uncheck the if no extension is provided, ustxt. As you see, I already added the XML at the end of the file, so the extension will be XML file. Now I'm going to close out of that. All right. We're going to choose the file back in DataDog. So click choose file here. There's our XML that we just created. So just go ahead and click open on that, please. And you'll see it pop just like that. So the next step is to enable. Update and enable, and it is installed. Now keep a copy of your single sign-on URL and your company ID from the sign-on URL. For the purpose of this video, I'm not showing it here. And please don't share this with anyone. This is your URL and your URL only. Do not give the company ID out to anyone. That would be a huge security mistake. Okay, so it's blurred out here. Once again, we're not going to show it. So go ahead and copy your single sign-on URL. As you can see by the following steps, we're going to have to click on the Identity Provider IDP Initiated Login. Make sure it's checked and save your settings. Then you'll want to navigate back to your Okta tab. Go back to your Okta tab. You should be back under your DataDOG under Applications. And go ahead and click Edit. Just double checking to make sure everything is good here. Okay, so scroll down to your company ID. And enter your organization company ID. Now go ahead and delete everything before the /LD and don't make the formatting mistake that I make here in this video. You want it to be a /ID/ followed by your company ID value. Now just doing a quick sanity check here, making sure everything is covered and all our bases are covered. And that should be it. Scroll all the way. And that's me rectifying my error. Now keep in mind again, it's /ID/. And that's it, should be done. Save your changes and feel free to open your Okta page and launch the DataDOG chicklet to ensure that the SAML integration is functioning properly and you're able to log in. We really hope that you enjoyed our series today and stay tuned for more.